the West Coast villains, the top players from West Coast. Actually, only one of them survived through signing up at 10 a.m.
Oh, man.
They capped at 32. Now, I believe in GC Yoshi, Bjorn, son of bears.
Okay. What else we
the
got?
The beautiful dude.
Okay. We also got Nerd Josh in the house.
Nerd Josh.
Yeah.
Hell Sap. All these people. And there's only one person that decided to wake up in time to sign up for the tournament legitimately.
Hey, it was.
And his name is Jason. Jason Wang, GC Yoshi himself.
Aww.
Being one of the, you know, made multiple top eights, has always proven himself to be a force to be reckoned with, at least in the USA. But this is an anime con tournament.
So what are the rules for this weekend, for this tournament?
This tournament is single elimination.
Yep.
So anything goes, guys.
Yeah, it is one and done. Miracles can't happen.
Now, there is a waiting list for all of our less fortunate players. So if anybody decides to, you know, just
drop out,
kind of wander off and, you know, wait in line and fall asleep somewhere.
Or get intimidated by the competition.
Yeah. No, definitely. You know, I can see that GC Yoshi is sitting right next to me right now, and he's got a J-Box thing. So I'm expecting some really weird stuff in that bag. But once again, guys, Anime Expo 2016, all the way in Los Angeles, California. It's gonna be fun. We see the to our left is the Daisuke booth with the huge Anisong World banner. Right next to that is the Bushi World
Bushi Road booth.
And I know that you worked with them for a while.
Yes, I do.
Are you still working with them?
Yeah, I still work with them for I'm an official Card Fight Vanguard judge, and so.
Yeah. So if you guys don't know, this is my good friend Will English, all the way from Chicago also.
Yes.
We're bringing you the doubles all the way from Chicago.
Yes.
And then
Midwest GG represent.
We're
in the building.
And, you know, Aksys, their booth is smack dab in the middle of this chaos.
Yeah. It is a huge booth. We have a huge crowd. I mean, I wish you could see the people standing around waiting for this to start.
Yeah, guys, you know, if you guys like the stream and whatever, just follow Josh at Joshua. You know, donate to him so he can actually get a real camera instead of, you know, this. The C920 cameras.
Yeah. Well, this is the starter set, right? And then later on.
I mean, he's got a really, really nice mixer. He's got the Aces laptop with I don't remember the capture card name. X capture card. So that's pretty expensive equipment. But yeah, he doesn't want to shell out for a camera for whatever reason. So guys, if you funded an Evo Fund Me, like you'll fund X person to go to Evo, spare like 50 cents to your local streamer so they can upgrade their...
I'll put 10 bucks on toward that.
You know, I don't know if Josh deserves $10. I don't know, man.
But come on, man.
Like, what has he done? What has Josh done? Yeah, Josh, what have you done? Exactly.
Oh. Wow.
But shouts out to the Atlas booth. They got Persona 5 going on strong over there. They got the Yakuza 0 demo, which is awesome. I have been a big fan of the Yakuza games for a very long time.
And not to forget, they also have the Central Fiction demo going on the other side as well.
Yes, we have the first console Central Fiction demo at Anime Expo.
Yeah.
So if you guys are still spending $1.50 per game at round one, you know, you got to come over here and, you know, start grinding, because you don't even need to pay money. You can lose to Jonah 100 times in a row if you wanted to and not pay a single cent.
But you have to get up after a couple of rounds, right? You have to play a couple matches.
Oh, yeah. I mean, there's literally an entire line lined up to face against the wolf and get really salty and then line back in line. You have to wait like 15 minutes to play Jonah again, unless you're the beautiful dude, because he cuts in line all the time.
But, man, that's how you learn, though. You gotta play. You learn from your mistakes. You get beat.
You know what's funny? He didn't even grow up in an arcade culture.
Oh, man.
So I don't know where he learned this debauchery from.
Oh, okay. I see.
Whoever is...
So he's an 09er is what you're trying to say?
He's like an 11er.
Oh.
Or something.
Wow,
I don't know.
Even
like,
worse.
Just look at him. Just look at him. Sunglasses indoors. You know, I'm wearing like a little, like, you know, Seth Killian blazer thing going on. It's
okay.
Like 80, 90 degrees in here. It's really, really hot.
Yeah.
But yeah, no.
It's Southern California in the middle of summer. Mm. It is extremely hot.
I know a lot of people have been asking me where I got the shirt from, and it is from Omocat, guys. If you guys like this shirt and like aesthetic t-shirts like this, please check out Omocat. Those guys make great t-shirts, great aesthetic wear. But once again, we're just kind of finalizing this bracket real fast.
Yeah.
And we'll be switching in names whenever somebody does not end up showing up.
Yeah, we still have time, ladies and gentlemen. If you're not on the waiting list right now, we got till about 1:15, and then we're going to start DQing people that haven't showed up, and then we'll add them to the waiting list. And so GC Yoshi may have a chance. I mean, he's on the waiting list, right?
GC Yoshi may have a chance. Bjorn, Son of Bears, may have a chance.
Okay.
And then everybody else, you know, I hope they really like playing against single and Lem Batman. I really hope they do.
The thing is, in single eliminations, time champions, if you get one good read, if you can read your opponent.
That's the thing, though, man. It's Batman. That's hard. You have to adjust.
I mean, it's just like the arcade, right? Winner stays on. Yeah. You know, you gotta fight for what's yours.
Sometimes, you know, fighting for what's yours is it's a very, very, very steep hill. And then, you know, if you get salty, you know, you have to go to a bathroom, you know, spit some water in your face, maybe buy a body pillow. I know I bought a couple body pillows already yesterday. They got some really nice body pillows, man. I'm telling you, if you're into Overwatch,
Oh, really?
I'm going to get... Guys, look at me.
Right? Oh, hold on. Look at me. Hold on.
They straight up have a Mercy Docky. I was saying this as a joke for the longest time, and they have it at Anime Expo. So if you guys are not at Anime Expo this year, you are missing so much. There are so many memes going on everywhere. There's Persona cosplay. There's Josh over here. He's like a walking meme. LPT's over there. He's a walking meme. Bjorn, Son of Bears, he's over there looking at his phone. He's the hugest scumbag you will ever meet.
Maybe we should get in like an exhibition match between him and GC Yoshi.
Yeah. An exhibition match between GC Yoshi and Bjorn, Son of Bears, to see who is the biggest master scumbag.
Yeah.
I mean, so GC Yoshi is really into NTR, and Bears looks like a vanilla kind of guy. So
this
will be a battle for the ages, guys.
Yeah, for sure. Old school versus new school, right?
Old school versus I don't even know if that's new school and old school. I'm gonna say that right now. That's like, hey man, do you like feet or armpits? That's not old school versus new school. I'll tell you that.
Fair enough.
Also, shouts out to the Toho game that's being played right now in the front.
Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, wow. Up first, we have GC Yoshi versus Random Anime Con goer number one being sacrificed to the lair of Jason.
Wait, so that means GC Yoshi got in?
Yes. He was the fourth person to sign up. That's what I said.
Oh,
yeah.
Nice. So we're going to see some Deadman action here. At least we know that part.
Oh, yeah. Once again, guys, Anime Expo, shouts out to Anime Expo, Arc System Works, Guilty Gear, Revelator, and Aksys Games are hosting this great thing. And then once again, guys, Joshua, follow, like, subscribe, donate again.
We're trying to get some camera stuff going. Wait, no. Is it GC Yoshi versus... No, okay.
Oh, wow, GC Yoshi versus Hellsap. Oh. First round, baby, let's go. Okay, so, guys.
Hype, Max, let's go.
Guys. I'm going to be real with you right now. I want you guys to type 1. One on a scale from 1 to 10, how salty is Hellsap going to be when he loses?
Wait, you're calling that right now?
And on a scale, and then right after that, I want you guys to type 11 to 15 on how emotionless GC Yoshi is going to be.
So GC Yoshi is on the left, and then Hellsap is on the right.
So first player is going to be Hellsap. Player 2 is going to be GC Yoshi. Also, shouts out to everybody at Anime's Expo wearing this extravagant cosplay in this weather, in this room. That is probably, you deserve my respect.
Is this a button check or is this real?
It looks like it's real, man. But once again, you know, it's a little bit hard to tell sometimes.
Oh, it's real. It's real. Yeah.
So Test is actually, letting Jacko get set up right now. He's got two houses, but
Hellsap. SAP.
And Hellsap has GC Yoshi in the corner, but, you know, GC Yoshi using Batman's Tri-Dash to just get past all of that stuff.
So Hellsop is a Jacko player. Okay, that's cool.
Yeah, he was a former Leo player. Kai, I believe. And he switched to Jacko for, because he really wants to win.
Yes.
Now, GCO, she's stuck in the corner right now, but finds the opening to get out. Gets the air throw and baits out the 360. Yeah, so Jacko has a invincible reversal. It is a 360 movement, and Calvados comes out. Counter hit, but goes the wrong way. That's very unfortunate. GC Yoshi slithering around. Hellsap, I wish Josh just saw that. The Hellsap was scratching his head. He's in distraught right now. GC Yoshi playing it very patient. Just not caring about any of these houses or these minions.
Oh boy, here we go.
He says, I hated Minions the movie. It was a terrible movie. The Japanese voice acting was even terrible. Did you guys know that they made a Japanese version of Minions?
What?
I found that out today.
Oh my goodness. Like, how do they I already want to know.
They have professional Japanese voice actors
doing the
Minions movie, man. That's pretty incredible.
Wow.
Anyway. Hellsap just kind of trying to get set up over here. But nice.
Good blitz. Just right back in the corner and then check. Oh.
Now, GCO, she's going to be looking out for that blitz this time. Hellsap not sitting on much meter, but, you know, run forward a little bit. You get all that meter back. OTGs.
He's got three pots that'll do it, so.
Yeah, so both of these, the wizards are at level two right now. Level three. Two houses at level two.
Wake up super.
Wake up super.
Nope.
Now that super is plus. This is a DP. Now, guys, if you guys did not know anything about Jacko, Jacko's DP and a lot of her special moves cost 25 meter to use.
Oh.
The first match goes to GC Yoshi. Look at Hellsap. Taking deep breaths, trying to laugh away the salt right now. And GC Yoshi, emotionless.
Yeah, he's just
looking like a young Confucius.
GC Yoshi is a killer, man. He just does not give it. Yeah.
We're going to try to keep it at PG-13 as we can.
I
don't know. What are the rules? You know, Josh never gave me the rules for commentary here. You know, I could start swearing up a storm right now.
Look, no, I want to keep it professional. Keep it professional. This is an audition tape, right? You know?
Yeah. You're right.
Okay, so special throw into the corner.
Almost had the combo. Oh, wow. Okay. I'm negative, so I'm going to DP the very MK mentality from Hellsap right now. Getting crossed up by the try dash again from GC Yoshi.
And here goes the replay. One, and do it again. And
oh,
do it
wow.
again.
That again. That jump D, putting in so much work for GC Yoshi.
Side still there. The repeat again. Oh, he blocks it this time.
I believe he went backwards to try to, like, get some damage on the houses, but in return, just kind of runs into a lot of GC Yoshi's buttons.
Wait. One down.
Combo. Deja
Here
vu.
Goes a repeat.
That's the B version or the slow version. So if that actually hits, it's gonna be a nasty a little nasty something coming.
Indeed.
Counter hit. Already committed to jumping backward. Projectile invincible shield. GCO just trying to wait out the time. Wait for the shield to go away. And the shield is going away, but the minions are so angry. They are saying, get off my waifu. This is not looking good for Hellsap anymore. The commentator's curse is definitely in full effect, guys. Nice DP once again to bait out.
Come on, Hellsap, you got this.
To bait out the Tridat. Running into the second hit of 6-8. Don't even need it.
Yep.
And that should be it.
That's game. So a very quick TO from GC Yoshi.
So guys, if you type in chat like a 4 or a 6, anywhere in between that, I give you props for that. If you said 11 for Jason, yeah, you're right. Because he definitely did not change a single. So there are players in the scene. They wear their emotions on their sleeve.
Yep.
They're very emotional players. You know, like Marlon Pai, he's got the face.
Right.
He's got a face. Like, Tasty Steve, always changing his facial expressions for whatever reason.
Right.
And then, you know, you got a lot of people that's kind of do the
I mean, you have people like Woshke, if you want to give like an extreme example. He celebrated before he get, you know, before his match ended and got beat.
You got people like that, you know, very stoic, and that I feel like that's so much willpower. You have to have so much willpower to do that.
Yeah,
like even Tokido cracks a smile sometimes.
I can't do that. Like my emotions are on my sleeve. I'm a very emotional player. Mm. But that's just...
You know who's not an emotional player? LPT. Doesn't take anything seriously.
And as I look over, he's, you know...
He's calming people and he's just laughing the entire time. Because he's like, wow, I'm so much better than you.
So up next we have Nerd Josh versus another guy. I don't know who's the other player.
So the first sacrifice to our my liege, Nerd Josh...
Still plays Elfeld even in Revelator.
Yep. Sticking with guns, you know, literally.
I mean, I saw Lost Soul play Jacko at Ciota.
Yes.
I thought he lost his mind. I was like, what's wrong with you?
I mean, there's definitely a lot of reasoning to it. But, you know, like what Tasty Steve and Ryan Hunter said, I bet he was thinking about what if I picked Elfeld during that tournament? Mm. What if? Like,
what
there's
if?
A lot of what if questions. And I like to live my life in the present, and I don't want to think about the past. So, you know, I'm always going to try to stick to my guns as best as possible.
Fair enough.
So
here we go.
Nerd Josh versus Griff, a Bedman player. This is the second Bedman we've seen today, actually.
That's the first. Nerd Josh fashion, here we go.
I really like that color with that Nerd Josh pick, though. Looking like a pastel Elfeld. I really like the pastel colors. Guys, if you draw stuff, you're at AX, and for whatever reason you're watching the stream, hit me up if you use pastel colors, because I love that stuff. I will give you so much money. Griff just not looking very comfortable in that Alpha matchup. Looking kind of confused, but you know, at least his facial hair is trimmed and groomed.
Yeah, sure.
It's looking very nice for Anime Expo.
Just those grenade mix-ups, you know, where do you block?
No Josh, actually dropping a lot of his combos right now.
Wow.
But you know what?
Extends the combo with the grenade.
Black beats. Oh, he forgot to throw it. Nerd Josh on tilt. Nerd Josh is on tilt, everybody. Nerd Josh is blowing up. Once again, back to neutral. Nerd Josh. So patient right now.
Black beat, throw it?
He's throwing it? No throw. That super is invincible, but is not throw invincible. And it is plus on block, so remember that, guys. What did he do?
The grenade got up.
That was the most active grenade I've seen in a while.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna lie.
So here we go again.
Very convincing round from Nerd Josh. Hopefully Griff can try to find his bearings right now.
Oh, this gets opened up by CQC and then
try to bait the burst. Griff was, he knew. He started. You hate to see that kind of thing happen, but he does have Nerd Josh in the corner and gets the Vital Express throw for his troubles.
Block.
Don't want to go out like that. One more round for Nerd Josh.
At least he had a good tournament experience, right?
Oh, yeah. No, I mean, some people really like to play against Nerd Josh, and I am not one of them.
Okay.
I'll tell you that right now. He's too good at fighting him. Sometimes it's fun, you know, if we're playing mystery.
Oh, wait. Commentator's supposed to make go reverse.
Whoa, okay. Nice forward dash out of the mix-up. The great action messing up the combo.
Ooh, good teleport
lock. Switching sides on accident, not used to Batman's hitbox maybe?
Oh, wow, that's good.
Using the block stun from both.
So Griffin has more defense this time around, it looks like. Oh, but then gets out in corner.
You cannot block.
Oh. Darn.
Nerd Josh with the savagery. He's feeling some sort of way right now. Come on, man, it's an anime con. You gotta chill out sometimes.
Boo!
Boo! You guys didn't hear it, but the crowd is literally booing Nerd Josh for thuggery. Thuggery to the max.
Well,
at least it looks really nice. You know, that nice button up.
Yeah,
got that
for sure.
Haircut,
for sure.
Very, very Nerd John style.
But the only way you learn is gotta play. It's just like Lotto, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Looks like up next,
we have...
Hold on. What is the next man?
Uh-oh. All right, so now I got Beautiful Dude.
I want to step off of this one. I don't even want to watch this.
Oh, come on, man. This is going to be good. This is going to be his idol exhibition.
Hey, Julian! 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 Wink at the camera.
There we go. That was the patented Beautiful Dude. He made a sound effect, apparently. You know, Josh's camera can't get sound effects. So, like, once again, you know, just toss a couple bucks his way. You know, he's got to eat sometimes. He really wants to buy this camera, man. Like, I cannot stress him up. Like, he's looking at me with a discerning face, and he's like, man, if I could get that camera, I could provide higher quality streams for generations to come, watch me play Guilty Gear really badly.
Of course.
No, he's not even that good at BlazBlue. What is Persona? That game's dead.
Oh, but yeah, Persona's dead.
Right, Josh? Right? Yeah, he's shaking his head at me. Yeah, yeah.
I mean, 1.2 would never come over here, so no point in even playing.
Yes, what is it, Alan?
This is Travis's. I'm giving you the stuff that I have to go. I told my game. So
where you got to go?
I have Gallery. Okay. So this is his stuff. Make sure you get
so,
that.
Okay.
He's on his way.
Beautiful
here.
Dude playing Zats. Oh, wait.
I'll put it in here.
Okay, yeah, yeah. Just let him know it's in there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Shouts out to having premiere badges and having friends that really want to go to idol events and making you waste an hour of your time so you miss everything else so he can get a Love Live tickets to meet a voice actor. Guys, I don't know if you know this, but idols are trash. Right, Jonah? Yeah, you're right. Even Jonah agrees. LPT agrees. He hates idols. Josh hates idols. Julian, look at him. He's wearing sunglasses indoor. He hates idols. Bears loves idols. That's why I can't like bears. Hellsap likes idols. He loves idols. That's why he plays Jacko.
So that's going to be swapped as vlogs, I think. Yep. There you go. So Beautiful Dude on Zato. And
he really wants. They really want to share this right now.
Oh, got another Elfo player. Okay.
Julian looking a little bit flustered right now at the moment. It's like, oh man, I have to play an Elfo.
Yeah, that's a tough matchup for Zato.
I wouldn't say it's a tough matchup, but you know, definitely it's a strange matchup because you can just kind of snipe little Eddie. You have to manage your meter a lot. You have to try a little bit harder, Zato.
Well, you got to find out openings where some may not exist.
Yeah. No, definitely. Oh, you're doing a button check. Okay, yeah. No, that's fine. Yeah. I don't know why you're telling me. I'm a commentator.
Okay.
And Julian with the terrible gold burst. Already mashing. Both players. Just the epitome of the most high-level Guilty Gear right now. Already going to character select. He says, I give up.
So first round to
First Griffin. Round to Alfeld. Once again, guys, if you do not know where we are at the Anime Expo 2016, brought to you by Joshua and Aksys Games. If you guys do not know, Zero Time Dilemma is out. You know, cop it now. That game is awesome. Super gritty, edgy. I'm all about that edge stuff, man. Like, look at Julian right now. He's doing the edgiest stuff he can do.
Oh.
Unfortunate burst from Edward. I don't know how much Zato experience he has. Bursting Noboru is almost never the smartest choice, especially at that height. And it looks like a perfect right now.
He's going to let him stay up. Or not.
Did not shake out of Dizzy fast enough, but... Julian, no...
No mercy.
No mercy, man. He definitely needs to buy that Mercy Daki, because he needs some mercy in his life. He needs to start playing some healers. Julian strikes me as the type of player that really does not play anything else but, you know, mashy characters.
or Overwatch. Like, Mashy characters in Overwatch. Like, he probably doesn't play a support class, a healer class. In an MMO, he would probably be the guy that gets hit by every AoE. In card games, he would be playing banned decks.
Double perfect from Julian. He's feeling himself. Switch to the camera. Julian is popping off right now. So hard. Look at him right now. He's
Bear is behind him looking so dissatisfied. Like, why am I not in this tournament? Why am I not taking Julian to the penthouse and giving him the...
Oh, wow.
Julian turning it down a couple steps right now, okay? That's what he's trying to do.
Oh, there we go. Try to reload the sniper rifle. It's kind of slow.
Man, you guys can't see this, but Bears is looking at Julian like, I'm going to take it to the penthouse tree, and I'm going to make you eat some Umaibo, you know what I'm saying? Like, he's going to eat some Umaibo.
Oh, bad burst from Edward here.
Dead man's hand.
Dead man's hand.
Julian's favorite move. I'm going to call that he's going to try to do it a little bit more this time. Kind of person that Julian is. No perfect this time. Counter hit by the drill is very, very scary. Oh, overhead.
Oh. I was gonna say, where's Ra from?
Nobru? Very strange setup from Julian. 2S, this goes right under anything Julian wanted to do. Ryan Express? Didn't even insta block, but still gets the throw. Wow, actually, what the hell was that? He crossed himself up because he didn't even know where he was going. Zato players, everybody. Nice.
Oh, wait.
Make a grab option select from Edward. Just kidding. Just kidding. Forget you, Julian. You don't know what you're doing.
Ooh.
He's trying to do it again. What a scumbag.
Oh.
And Invito Hell takes it. Good stuff to Edward, though. He definitely got Julian down to a respectable health amount, and that is not very easy to do for a player of Julian's caliber. It's very hard, unless you're me, because I beat him up all the time for whatever reason.
You know that matchup well, huh?
I know that's my favorite matchup. I play it all the time. I'm gonna hop off the mic for a quick second. I can wait. I need to talk to Aksys Mike. We have this very, very nice liter of beer that Alan brought all over from the East Coast.
Really?
Apparently, he says that this is the S-tier beer. And being a beer connoisseur,
yeah.
I really need to try it.
Does he have
and we're inviting Aksys Mike with us, so. I know that he is also a beer connoisseur. Shouts out to Bryce if he's watching right now. Very unfortunate that he could not make it because he is a homeless person right now.
Oh.
No job. Has a girlfriend.
Okay.
Has bills. Like, he is the epitome of, I need a job right now. I have a girlfriend and I have bills.
How is he going to work that out?
Bryce is a nice guy. He lives in Canada. He'll eventually find a job. Yeah, I think he definitely can. So, no worries for Bryce, but I really wish he could have made it out to Anime Expo this year. It looks like Foo actually got into the bracket somehow.
Oh, man.
What is this nonsense?
So, more killers for...
Yeah, no, this is looking like a pretty... pretty okay tournament now.
Okay.
Foo with the broken PS2 pad. Actually, this is a new one, actually. That's funny. The one he had at Frosty's, the D-pad was so sticky. Like, I tried to do movements on it. It was, like, oily and sticky, and, like, the D-pad was broken. So, like, if you held it the wrong way, it would stab you. That was not a cool controller, man. And he was doing like, he was doing 5-6K loops on it and stuff. Once again, guys, shouts out to Anime Expo, Dustloop, even though nobody ever goes through there anymore. I think the last post was like 3 months ago. Aksys Games for providing us with the great tournament Aksys atmosphere at Anime Expo.
So Fu is playing Kyum. You know, yes. Two characters in one.
The tuner herself.
Now, this is with a
very new character. All I know is a lot of people say that her as a character,
yes,
very strong, a lot of hitting potential. And I know that Josh, Dane Josh from East Coast, really likes this character also. Yeah, a lot of unexplored opportunities.
I don't know too many Kyum mains at the moment, but I'm sure they'll will reveal themselves as time goes on.
Oh yeah, definitely. And I know that Fu also is a Potemkin sub also, so okay. He's gonna know this matchup very well. But with a new character, you know, it's always a little bit tricky. Hammerfall, block, no cancel.
Oh,
no red. Cannot relaunch from that. Okay. That close slash from Tuner is ridiculous. I believe it is very plus, and it's almost on Alpha tier. He's leaving that ball in front, trying to bait out a flick.
And Fu taking the first round very convincingly. Oh, uh-oh. Oh, it looks like...
counter.
It looked like there was a desync, but...
Right, throwing out the H-fire, but once again, Fu really likes to use it. So it's a little bit slower, but, you know, lasts a little bit longer, has more hits,
has more range.
You can do some set play like this. Trap. Oh wow, okay. Not sure what he tried to do that. I believe he tried to go for the DP loop, but might have messed up the input. But the slide head again. Trying to go for that gimmick right now. Is that play? Oh, just getting hit. Oh. Fu very content on just staying at that mid range. Not blocking these slide heads. The mix-up. The 50-meter, the 100-meter mix-up. Really needed that knockdown, but unfortunately the shield hit him at the same time. Nice round start 2P from Potemkin. Probably one of his fastest and farthest round starts in the game. Knock down, or just not blocking.
Whoa! Oh, there's a burst.
Whoa! He's feeling some sort of way right now. That was the biggest read. Super fireball. That fireball comes out so fast, and he can control it in any direction he wants. That is a low that time. So if you guys didn't know, both her overhead and her low look relatively the same, so it is you're gonna have to guess on that that blocking that after the fireball.
So Kyum on match point here.
Nice 5-H to interrupt that special. 6-H. Full combo punish. Sorry if I'm not speaking too much, guys. I just lost all my energy. For whatever reason, hunger just hit me like a train.
Oh, boy. Get this man some pizza or something. Or some pocky.
Here we go. Whoa! So many hands. She gave him the hands. Shouts out to ERY, though. Good stuff with Potemkin. You know, unfortunately that he had to run into Fu so early in this bracket.
So
So full advances. So has anybody from the top from the killers been eliminated yet?
No.
Okay.
None of them have faced each other yet, and I'm excited to see it.
I don't know where Bears went. Is he gone forever? Are we not going to see the appearance of Bears?
No, the son of Bears.
Yes, the Bjorn, son of Bears. Somebody get LPT over here so he can give me some chips.
Yo.
I'm starving.
There we go.
Thank you.
Did you want some?
Yes.
Once again, guys, shouts out to LPT for being the biggest scumbag in the world. These Pringles aren't even good. Wow. Did you just mute me? Shouts out to Joshua muting me while I'm trying to annoy the stream with the beautiful a cappella of crunching Pringles. Once again, guys, you can kind of see the outline of the a small part of the venue crowd. The venue crowd, we actually have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 setups here. A couple with BlazBlue and a couple with Guilty Gear. And everybody is lined up across this booth. Some people are buying Zero Time Dilemma, which is out now. Shouts out to Aksys Games. They have a lot of great merch here, like shirts, apparel. I'm actually going to end up buying my copy of Guilty Gear Revelator here because apparently where I live by my parents, there is not a single game store that has Revelator in a 500-mile radius.
Wow.
And I'm not trying to buy it online. I like to have physical copies. I'm weird.
Well, this is the perfect place to pick it up, right?
Yes, exactly.
Directly from the source.
It's a lot cheaper, too, than any of the other game stores. It's only $40 over here. So, guys... Yeah. Reasonable price to Guilty Gear. You know, probably one of the beautifulest game, fighting game for the PS4 out right now.
For sure. So, for your players you don't know, it looks like it's going to be a Soul versus Guilty Gear.
I see that that shirt is not PG-13 right there. That is that's a pretty not PG-13 shirt right there. You see that right? Right,
yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. We're not gonna draw attention to it, unfortunately.
Okay. So Ami versus Kiri. Nope.
And this looks like a bug. Yeah. This looks like a bug deck.
It's not a button check.
It's not?
No, it is not a bunch check, I believe. Okay, no, that is a bunch check. I lied.
Called it.
Nailed it. Don't blame me sometimes, alright? It looks real, and at an anime con, you can never know what to expect.
Right. So we got a Soul versus Elf belt matchup.
Now, I believe this matchup is actually, pretty even for the most part.
Okay.
When Alpha gets started, you know, it's a little hard, but Saul has so many answers.
Oh wow!
To a lot of the stuff that Alpha does.
Red flame. Surprised he didn't follow that up.
Ooh. Fafnir, why is he Fafnir? He's feeling some sort of way right now.
He's getting aggressive here.
Oh.
Yep. Air slash.
Standard BMP. You can throw that. That is very negative on block. Oh. Captain, once again, getting the dust loop.
Hey. Oh, nope. Oh.
Alright, Alpha has him in the corner now. Blocked his mix-up. Nice DP out. Alpha has to realize that she cannot just kind of run her standard game on a lot of stuff. Just because Sola has one of the better...
Alpha throws. Rare RC, shotgun stance, reload. Oh.
That's so much damage.
Wow.
Hey. The grade.
Somebody else knows too.
Okay,
I guess all Alpha knew was a corner here.
Sol sitting on 100 meter right now.
Oh.
Messes up. I believe he tried to do a ground.
Raw dust, there we go.
Bringer. Yeah, guys, if you don't know, if you're in the air or not, just wait a couple seconds longer. Red RC helps you combo. It slows down the game so much, you can just kind of take your time to kind of think about what just happened. All right, nice. I actually really like him using that blocking right there because Alpha was holding on a grenade, and he knew it was going to blow up.
Here we'll go.
There you go.
Hello.
That's going to be a lot of damage. Oh, it bursts up the Grand Viper. Alpha has still back in the corner. This is where he's going to do some work. All right, the purple RC, we get out of that. Oh, that's overhead.
And then man throw. A little bit too quick on that and that draw from Kirin. Oh.
Should be around for Kirin in a couple seconds here. Sees that one last hit. There you go.
A 5K two ticket.
So match point for Kirino here. And I can say this early, but Omni's fighting for his tournament life.
Yes, it is a single Elim tournament, guys. Finally, the first grab to come out. That string is very not safe.
There we go.
Right.
Oh. Gotta watch that DP.
Alright, DP's out again.
Wow. Grab. I'm gonna read that next time.
Well, press. That could have been so much damage to Kirino. Grand Viper. I like the wire CM wake up actually.
Oh, wow.
Could have gotten a little bit more damage, but
you know. Mix up here for. Oh, Alpha puts it back in the corner. It gets around. Okay. There's some life in Omni yet.
No, I actually don't know if Kirino knows that Alpha has a strange wake-up time than a lot of the other casts. Because it looks like he went for an empty low and just got scooped up.
So Omi's getting a little bit more excited since he got that round. So he has some life left.
Lots of momentum going toward Omi.
Oh, wow. There we go.
Omi. Right
Big deep piece of again.
Wow.
Oh, raw dust.
Hey. Gives it simple.
Gunflame? No?
Oh, it gets Gold Burst. I hate waking up Gold Bursting against Souls. Just because of Derek. He's made me scared of a lot of things.
Good blocks, grab, but.
Mana Bringer, Fafnir.
Hey.
Let's try to go for the same
shot. Oh, raw throw.
Scoops. Scoop. Messes it up.
Oh, that's a shot.
Omni has a chance, and he throws him out. This is the momentum he needs. There we go.
First about.
Alpha fighting for her life right now. Oh, my God. And the run-up DP. Kirin up. Takes it over Omi. Omni.
It was a good effort, though. It was a good effort.
That was almost a very, very strong comeback.
We almost had a third game here, but it's all been 2-0 so far.
Good to take a look at the bracket right here, guys.
Yeah.
Hi, Hannah.
Go ahead.
Hi, Hannah. Also, shouts out to Christian for helping run the Revelator tournament, guys. And he said he's a really bad CEO, so. Actually, no, never mind. Take away that shout out.
Just take it back.
We're not taking it back. I can do that. I'm a commentator.
The power of your voice compels you.
Once again, guys, Anime Expo 2016 brought to you by Aksys Game and Joshua. Like, subscribe, donate for a new camera.
The new camera fund starts now.
New camera fund, man. Yeah, his PayPal is screaming. He's like, hey, man, we got a couple donations already for like,
let's see,
25 cents.
Do we have any cash on here right now?
We have a Burger King receipt, a Wendy's coupon. Hey, man, you gotta
save money.
Free Frosties. Free Frosties at Wendy's, you know? Yeah. That's like a dollar something to the camera. Yeah. I take it.
Yeah, sure. So looks like we have our first Jam player.
Jam, regarded as probably one of the weaker characters in the new BlazBlue. And the new BlazBlue, Jam is considered it. No, I'm so sorry, guys. Wait, that's been a little bit of a doozy yesterday, but Jam is considered one of the weaker characters in the new Guilty Gear Revelator.
Okay.
But there are definitely players that have proved themselves with this character, much like Doran 2K, aka Doran the God 2K.
Yep.
And many more. Sway, shouts out to Sway, another Jam player from the East Coast. But you know, if you like the character and you stick with her, you probably will go pretty far. I mean,
Guilty Gear is a game of character specialists. You know, you don't play the matchup, you play the character. So
yes. like Fab. Like Fab plays the worst character in the game, but yep. You know, he's godlike. So yes.
He's got the reads.
You gotta become the next Jam Fab. Is what I'm trying to say.
Yes, sir.
Very, very passive start from both of these players. 6-8, just doing it. Just a grab. No combo ender. Gets the card. Right, burst out. Makes her use the card. Oh, oh counter wow. 6-8. Should have been so much damage. I don't know how well burst Endo run is at Guilty Gear, but.
Oh, what punish again?
Tihenna making Jam look like a monster character. Oh, here we go. Dragon install, baby.
Let's go.
Let's get the blood pumping. Tihenna just kind of taking his time. Making whiff punishing very well against Ando run.
I mean, if he's going to keep pushing buttons, he might as well let him do it. Oh, Grand Viper just underneath it. Reporter just pushed troubles.
S anti-air. Wow, run up, parry the kahunas on this Jam player right now. Counter is 2-H. Oh my god. If Enderun could only confirm into a very, very solid hit, maybe a very basic BMB, Tihenna would be in so much trouble. But right now, Tihenna's still on a life deficit. Dangerous spot for both of these players, both sitting at 100 meter.
100 meter and burst. Yeah, there we
burst,
go.
Burst gone.
Oh, there we go.
It shouldn't be death.
Nope.
Not just yet. Andrew Reelin. Oh, here we go. We got it. DP. No.
Oh.
Maybe next time.
We're waiting for the hype with the dragon install here.
That was ridiculous, though. That was 3 2-H's in a row without it connecting. I respect Tihenna for not hitting any buttons during that. But I really wanted to see him hit a button. 6-H OTG. Wow!
Oh, nice.
The low air throw, looking like Shades of Nebraska right now. Six H once again.
Because it works the first time, do it again.
Like, you know, Andrew Ryun says, I don't really know combos that well with Saul, but my footsies are on another level.
Oh, here we go.
You might call. Oh my God!
Got that.
The footsies. This man has footsies.
Burst out. Come on, get the.
Oh,
there we the go.
Footsies.
There we go. I love it.
Call him Young Gutex, because his shimmy is ridiculous.
We're right back. Right back to business.
Gets the card. Hard knockdown. What's the next up? Just late IAD. Andrew Young not looking too good right now. Drops the combo though.
Oh.
Brain stomp blocked. 2H again with Bandit Revolver. That is very negative. Gunflim runs into it. No combo. 6H. Let's go, baby. Oh, DP. First DP of the day.
Oh,
let's go.
Here we go. 2H.
Yes, oh, 2P.
Yes.
Oh. Tihanna with the smart super. The smartest super.
Oh man, it's too much hype, too much hype.
Okay, oh, tried to go for the kick throw, but Andrew Ryun is not taking it. Just 6H, 2H, ground Viper.
Burst out.
Hit by the gun blade, riot stamp, no avail. I don't think a single riot stamp has hit. Good stuff to Tihanna. Counter hit, 5H. Oh. Andrew Ryun needs to get his footsies in place. That is not going to connect.
A little bit too far.
2H counter, or no avail. You gotta go. 2H counter, 2S counter hit. Grand Viper blocked. Big punish. Oh, big.
Oh, it's a go.
Oh, here we go, baby.
Oh,
the first insta-kill of the Anime Expo tournament. Shouts out to Tihanna. Wow. Good stuff to Andrew Ryun, though. You know, you saw some use of some footsies, some very basic game knowledge, fighting game knowledge. On the screen in front of me right now is the first double KO of the Anime Expo tournament. Not being streamed.
Good stuff, though. Good stuff, though. So. So now we got the Persona cosplayer.
Yep.
Versus. And of course, we're going to wait for Christian for the matchup here. No. Sadly.
Who dares enter the main?
Okay, so
Rover and meat soba.
Elite soba, like the noodles.
Oh, elite soba. I thought you said meat. I'm sorry. Hey, he's wearing Chie cosplay meat soba. I'm gonna call him. His name is Elite Soba. I'm gonna call him Meat Soba. Doesn't soba have meat in it already?
No.
No. It should.
Soba's noodle.
Hey man, I would eat some meat soba. This is like ground beef, basically, right?
I guess.
Ground beef noodles. If somebody has not made that yet, you know, I kind of want to see it. It sounds kind of gross. But elite soba.
Looks like the first Mei player of this tournament.
Puffball. Puffball. Trying to go over again. Random whale super does not hit. Mr. Dolphin does connect though. Counter hit sweep. Messing up his charges a little bit.
Oh, another random super.
Actually connects. Okay, first round will go to Rover.
Dual.
Oh, wow. Oh. The Dragon Kick going right underneath Maze Far S. Ooh. That's big damage. Counter hit puffball. Shades of AC, baby. It's not blocking. Wake up. Rover, or Elite Soba, Meat Soba, has really needs to start blocking on Wake Up. Rover getting kind of tossed around in the corner right now. Oh boy. Let's get out.
Little sense of meter to get the combo.
Oh, okay, and the 2K 5H to take it. Yes, guys, this is the squeak on squeak fight, if you have not noticed. Both of these characters probably was the most annoying voices of Guilty Gear Xrd. Try to go for the instant air dash DP mix up. Whoops. Nice parry, but a little bit too far to really get anything off it. Uses the super. Unless it's, oh no, it does connect, okay. Jump 2H. Just backing off, trying to get some space, trying to set up his dolphins and his otters. Random whale! Random whale! Oh. It hits Hellfire, baby! This is anybody's game right now. This is actually pretty risky. Rover's looking for the super. Yep, there it is. It's not hit. And the 2P, 2P!
Match point for Rover.
Rover looking very solid right now. Will we have another jam player win? Buddy.
Wow.
Drops the Nsenga Ender. Counter it. Which instant block from Rover? Oh, counter hit puffball. A little bit too far from the corner.
Oh, try to.
It's okay. He blocked it. A little bit too close to that 3-8 to not be punishable.
Super.
Not gonna kill. Oh, and the instant overhead, red RC.
Is the Chicago Burst right there?
Yes. But Elite Soba is still not done yet. Good trade for Elite Soba, I mean. Yet again. Oh, that jump 2H is putting in so much work for Elite Soba right now.
All right, so some life left for Elite Soba.
Rover still sitting on a match point, though.
Maybe we can get a third game out of this, maybe.
Not looking very good for Elite Soba right now, but May does hit like a truck.
Oh, wow.
Mr. Otter puts out the beach ball.
Oh, counter. Sprays it in super.
Once again, Mr. Dolphin gets hit by the mix-up. Oh, he tried to bait the burst. Random whale. No avail. Oh, man, I got bars.
Did you hear that? You got, I got bars, man.
Random whale, no avail. Oh! Bars!
You should open up a record label, like, right tomorrow.
Yes, right now.
It's called the EXE label.
Hey, man. Sometimes it's just, you gotta do it.
So it looks like Nerdjoss is sitting down.
Not on the stream today.
Not on stream. But GC Yoshi.
Yeah, no, the tournament is definitely looking like it's winding down. We got our, this is gonna be, I believe, the second round.
Okay.
So Bears did not make it.
So it's GC Yoshi and victim number two.
Once again, guys, Anime Expo 2016. Shouts out to Aksys Games. If you have not picked up a copy of Zero Time Dilemma, I would suggest you do so. That game is gritty as all hell.
Yes.
Super cool game.
You should play the game with lights on in the house, you know, sun out and everything.
Sometimes you just gotta take it like a man, you know. Playing in a dark room with no water around you. Make sure you're in a really old house, so everything's just the right scenery.
So you don't know whether it's the game or the house, you know, creaking and stuff like
that. Yes, of course.
Or even better, play Fatal Frame, you know.
You know, Fatal Frame is actually the first game that made me think my house was haunted.
Yep.
And then I realized my house is probably haunted.
I can play Resident Evil no problem, but Fatal Frame got me every single time.
I don't know, man. Have you seen the new Resident Evil that's coming out? Resident Evil 7 looks ridiculous. Made by the same team that worked on PT. Also, shouts out to Spark. I don't even know why he's here. How the hell did Spark get here? All the way from T&W.
So next up we have GC Yoshi versus I-211.
Heaven or hell.
I guess.
That sounds like an Illinois tollway.
No, that's 290, but anyway.
Yeah.
But
Random Pride stop, no avail.
Some early aggression from two, I'm just gonna call it 211. Yeah. But going against GC Yoshi's godlike Bedman.
Oh.
Corner, replay. The 2-1 deck. I think went for a command throw and just GC Yoshi said, yeah, I'll just do the backup and punch
that.
That's all good.
She's really, really good at making the correct reads at times. Oh, 6B, knock him out of the air. OTGs, riot stamp, or break, to the Karo.
Sets up replays there. Oh.
Cannot riot stamp through that. Grand Viper.
Oh, caught him looking.
Watch your toes, GC Yoshi. Once again, to the Karo. Big punish. Ooh, first out. It's not over yet. Oh, here we go, baby. Let's go.
What? What's that?
He's gonna get dizzy. Saul's just gonna, yeah.
What is the kill?
Can we go to the player cam real fast? I want a moment of silence for a fallen comrade. You can see GC Yoshi actually smiling. Rare moment of emotion on GC Yoshi's face. But yes, guys, a moment of silence for a fallen comrade. Let's
rock. Amen.
GC Yoshi's just the worst kind of person. Ooh. Another block riot stamp. Another riot stamp. Actually hits this time. No combo.
Oh, where did you burst there?
Unfortunately, that he did not get the. Wow! The mix up! What was that? That was crazy. I didn't even see him throw a B task.
That's how good GC Yoshi is.
Oh!
Can you blitz those?
Oh, here we go again. Once again. A. Combo extension.
And teleport behind.
GC Yoshi has the meanest look on his face right now.
All or nothing. So mash point for GC Yoshi. It's been nice.
Good 6B. That is actually the first time a riot stamp has actually been anti-air today. Alright, gets the combo. Good job. GC Yoshi just reacting to this. Oh, that's an unfortunate burst. Domi. Oh, here we go. Let's go, I-2-2-2-1-1. Let's go. Gunflame, just trying to build some meter. Riot Stamp, no avail. Once again, has nothing to replay. Air! Dragon Assault, uh-oh. Nothing. Oh, he hits him, he gets hit. So much damage.
No.
Oh, OTG, that's not. Not yet.
Tried the insta-kill, didn't work.
GC Yoshi actually has no meter right now. And GC Yoshi will take it.
Oh, that's unfortunate. Another victim for the slaughter.
No, it's, like I said, once again, you know, he probably got out first round in the single Elim bracket. Remember, guys, this is single Elim.
Yeah.
Anything goes. And he had to run against GC Yoshi. One of the scumbags players. One of the biggest scumbags.
Yeah, yeah. For real, for real. So I'm just waiting for when a killer versus killer gets eliminated. That's gonna be real fun.
Oh man, I'm gonna be talking so much smack. It's ridiculous. Looks like Fu is gonna be up now.
Okay. Fu versus SV. It looks like. And then on the stream station, but the station next to us, the beautiful dude is playing right now. It looks like he is
playing against Saul. Yeah. Now the crowd has thinned a little bit. You know, a lot of people have been getting knocked out of this tournament so far, and you know, you can see from the player cam, it's kind of dying down. So a lot more people are jumping onto the BlazBlue console release or console demo.
So we.
A lot of people have been asking, you know, when is BlazBlue console coming out, or when can I try it out? You know, you can try it out right now.
Yeah, you can try it out today.
At AX. This entire weekend. Crazy, right?
It looks like Beautiful Dude has just won his match as well.
Yep. Are we at top 8 now? How far are we from top 8? Oh, it's top 8 now. Oh, okay.
Oh, okay.
Right after that, okay.
Heaven or hell. Duel 1. Let's rock.
It looks like Fu actually whipping out the Potemkin versus Jam.
Wow. And the confidence.
Oh, he's trying to read. He's sure had to go for the hard read right there. Safe jump. Oh, nope. I don't know if this is. Oh, yeah, it does connect. Okay. Not much damage against Potemkin.
Oh, what was that about?
Probably a misinput on SV side. Is this K-loops? Yep.
GP. Oh, so it looks like we're entering into top 8.
Yep.
And do I see Vicioso sitting down to play? This is the GA cosplayer.
Counter hit. Nice 6-8 to go right underneath that 2P.
Oh, chucking a lot of dust, but oh.
Try to continue the combo, but a little bit too far. Same jump again.
Oops. Hit again.
He's getting knocked down a lot.
The pot buster.
The old school. 5P whiff in the pot buster.
So Fu up 1-0. He's either fighting to get in top 8 or he's in top 8, but this is
I believe this right after this is going to be top 8.
Okay, so whenever this gets into top 8.
Did he punish?
Oh. Fu didn't burst out of that, but
pop up yet again, not looking good for SV.
Oh, he's gonna finish this out. Popbuster again. There you go. Those command throws get you every single time.
Light head, connects. Safe jump. Oh. Meaty 5K. Shades of AC.
Oh, wow, does the real.
Hey, this is my favorite combo, like, unless he drops it. Gets the grab.
Oops. Oh, bursts out.
the card. Oh,
we're gonna finish this up. Oh.
Wash your toes, son. Oh my god, wake up 5T, Shades of Faust.
Dude just splits them to death, huh?
Yep.
So 2-0 for Fu.
Good stuff.
He gets into top 8.
2 SV though. Not easy playing against Fu.
SV walks out, what, 11th place?
I don't even know how single Liam brackets work like that, so I play too many double even.
Haven't we all? Haven't we all? So we should be going into top 8. So the next up is going to be Beautiful Duke versus Rated Shadow Xrd.
Okay.
I mean, if you have Xrd in your title, I assume you're a good player.
Yeah, I assume you have some knowledge of the game.
So. Beautiful Duke with Zato. I do not know what Shadow plays.
Hey, Julian! Give the stream some love!
There we go.
He has to do that every single time, right?
Gotta keep this tournament a little bit exciting, at least.
Oh, once again, guys, shouts out to everybody that's working at the Aksys Games booth. It is really hot in here, and I'm wearing a really thin blazer, so it's not really helping, but...
In Southern California in the middle of summer.
Southern California in the middle of the summer. Whoa, Anime Expo, guys. Crazy, crazy fun. To my right, there are the metal dive cat, whatever things.
Yeah.
Those things are cool as hell, man. I still have not been able to walk around the dealer much. I've just been kind of doing a lot of stuff
So who is that character, by the way?
Which one, on the right?
Yeah.
I'm not talking about the cosplay. I'm talking about the statues.
Oh.
Yeah. But that cosplay is pretty awesome. That's a Monster Hunter cosplay.
Oh, okay. Legit. So here we go. Top 8 action here. Beautiful Dude versus...
Button check. Terrible gold burst from Julian. I don't even know why he's gold bursting at this single point. This is the worst Guilty Gear play I've ever seen in the tournament of history.
I mean, who goals burst after the first 2 seconds? Like,
hey, to be fair, Lost Soul did it against Kid Viper at CEO. It might have been an input error. It might have been, you know, he thought he was going to do like a far slash or something and wanted to get that meter, you know, ASAP. But yeah,
and he had to hold that for that match?
Yeah, he had to hold it.
Damn. Well.
You know, a lot of things happen in fighting games, man. Yeah, mess-ups happen.
Jitters.
Yeah.
Missed inputs. Drop combos.
Right. Start of the round, Invital Hell comes out. Little Eddie falling across the ground. Very patient from Raven Shadow Exit right now.
I think he's familiar with...
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Wake up, Gold Burst, Julia. Very patient. This is probably one of the most patient stalls I've seen play against Zacho. He's kind of running away, letting Beautiful Dude come to him.
Wow. Okay.
A little bit no follow up. The axe kick.
Just goes on.
Where it begins.
Oh. Overhead.
Right. Invite help, meaty, shadow. Wow. Actually messing up the combo and Raiden Shadow Xrd recognized it. Just DP'd in between. Nice back dash back. Kills little Eddie. That's a lot of momentum, but you know, I don't know if he can come back with his life deficit right now. Yeah, and Noboru will take it. Oh, the fake into the Fafnir.
Oh.
Grand Viper to escape from Nobiru.
Oh, okay.
One of the hard knockout, but a little bit too high.
Going to the corner for his troubles. Here comes the vortex, but Soul bursts
out. Nobiru counter hit.
Tokyo Death.
Space out the DP. That was an SDP right there.
So I see Nerdjosh sitting down as well, so he's going to be playing his match.
Nerdjosh versus... Ooh, I really want to see that one. Wow. And that's going to be off-screen, guys. Gunflame tagging the beautiful dude. Wake up Goldberg yet again. This is the second time he's done it.
If you can get out of the way early, you can recover back to the next match.
Kind of plan it slow. Zato zoning against the rated Shadow Exer right now. Try to take a burst. I'm seeing a lot of
Oh. That was an unfortunate burst.
Counter hit Nobiru. Oh, messes up the Shadow Gallery loop. Neutral being played right now. Meaty low drill, guys. Okay, so trying to feel out the neutral right now. I like what Shadow Rated Xrd is doing though. He's recognizing where these the pools are, the shadow pools are, and he's using Gunflame to then to get them away. Unfortunately, Julian just in control of this matchup right now. Nice. Cross under.
Oh, unfortunate burst.
Yeah, and it will be it. Beautiful D knocks Shadow Rated Xrd out of the tournament.
So. That puts Beautiful D in top four, right?
I believe so, yeah. Top eight,
single winner,
yep. So good stuff, Julian. The next match will definitely be a little bit harder.
So
we're coming into the ending, and the ending is where all of the skill comes to play. Or goes to play.
Yeah, so
comes to play.
GCOC is still in, so is Nerdjosh, so is Beautiful Dude.
Who is playing against Nerdjosh right now, actually.
Oh boy. So this may be our first killer match.
It looks like Nerdjosh just won a match, so that might have been the first round, or first match. Once again, guys, shouts out to AX 2016. This is probably like the 18th time I've said it. But also shouts out to Joshua. If you guys can, like, subscribe, donate for a new camera,
yep.
Et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And once again, I am joined here with my good friend, Will English the Fourth.
I appreciate that.
All the way from Chicago, guys.
Yep.
So, you know, give us a follow. I don't remember what your Twitter handle is.
It's just my name. Everything's my name. You know, Twitter, Facebook, everything is Will English IV. So.
And then give me a follow also if you want. I am at NobodyXE. Sadly, I will not be at Evo this year, so.
What?
Yeah.
What happened?
I went here.
Oh.
I don't know. I really haven't been playing that many games, but I like exploring
okay.
a lot. You know, I like having talks with a lot of the players, you know, seeing what's new. Melt Kaicho and Kirino.
Milk Kaicho.
Guys, if you are at AX and watching the stream for whatever reason, or you're close to the area and you're not here, I don't know what you are doing. Get off the stream right now after you subscribe and follow. And head toward Anime Central or Anime Expo.
Oh, come on, man. Come on now.
I'm sorry. There's a lot of anime.
Yeah, I understand that.
Anime Expo. There is so much to do right now. there's a couple concerts I really want to go to, but I miss like the yeah.
Shut up, Josh.
So there's a lot of there's gonna be a giveaway today at I believe 3 o'clock at the Aksys booth. So oh wow, oh here we go. No Kaicho, already setting out one of the houses. And the command grab. Counter hit 2S. Now, I really don't agree with him backing away from that gunflame and letting his houses take damage, because he did have the shield out. And the shield does negate all projectiles. That counter hits the stage. Try the 2S, but jump 8 is not a thing to be reckoned with against Soul. Try to go for an air reset to throw. Nice Amare. 6-8.
Oh, first half of the work.
Houses. Cross him to the outside. Oh, yeah, ride stamps. It's not working out. A lot of these ride stamps that a lot of the Soul players of this tournament have been trying to do is just.
Now, just throwing it out randomly as if it's with Mech, and then...
I mean, it's a good test to see what they do, but a lot of people have not really been...
Oh, here danger, we go! Danger time!
Oh, snap! Oh, snap! Oh, snap! Here we go. Waiting.
Come on.
Nice. Very nice defense from No Kaicho. Oh! You can't hit that. You can't throw that after a certain point.
Wait, Learn Josh has lost one game.
Yeah, it's 1-1 on the other screen right now. But Mil Kaicho definitely looking very good against Gary now. Calvado. I love the use of Calvado. Oh, and he messes up the Bandit Bringer. It's a simple. Bubba does not know Jacko's weight restrictions. All houses level 3, baby. This is scary. Angry minions. It's like Hot Topic is assaulting you with all their little minion figurines. Oh, DP's through the burst. And dies to Chip. Yeah, no, you can. You have to be FDing during that.
Game 2.
No Kaicho. Very strong. Oh, and a bad burst.
We'll get it back though. Let's go to the other side. Hey.
He's a short. Yeah. I respect that. Hey.
We're working on a perfect here. We can get the follow-up mix up here.
Try to go for the grab. Not attacking. Wow, he was searching. Mil Kaicho was searching for an answer, just could not find a way out.
Domination, here we go. Maybe some life yet.
3-H counter. Wow, and the 2-H counter hit. Working out for Kirino. Got the shield and the minions are enraged. Alright, nice dead angles. Does not want to mess with any of these minions. Minions are just filling the screen right now. We got 3 level 2 houses. 1 level 3 now. 2 level 3. I'd really like to see Kirino just start to hammer away on these houses.
It's not over yet.
Gunflame. Oh. So many minions. Oh, it takes the burst. I do not like that burst usage right there. When you're down that much, when you're at a life deficit at that low health, I feel like it's almost just not necessary to burst.
Yeah, save it for your next round. Because
right now, I don't even think he's going to be able to get his burst back.
No,
he should go right underneath the revive stamp. Bates another DP. Baiting so many DPs right now.
Oh. So, go for super.
The minions! The minions! And yep, that's fighting Jacko in a nutshell, guys. And so you cannot let her get started. You have to be hitting those. You have to be hitting those. You can't let them get a level 3.
Yeah, because Zerg Swarm, if you know about that from StarCraft.
Yeah, exactly. Zerg Swarm. But you. If you are doing nothing in the matchup and there are houses out, you should be throwing out some stuff there. At least put some damage out on the houses.
Alright, so it looks like Beautiful Dude has been called. And it looks like Nerd Josh just won his match. So, who's out?
Yes. Who is out of the tournament? Nerd Josh has defeated Tuner.
So, GC Yoshi, who's he gonna have to kill? He's gonna have to kill Beautiful Dude or
Nerd Josh or Milk Kaicho.
Oh man, I could definitely go for some food right now. You have to
put that yawn in, man. It's earlier in the day.
I definitely need some food, though. I woke up and I looked at the food trucks that are outside of Anime Expo. Yeah, sushi burrito, all that stuff. Except the lines are redonkulous.
So it looks like Julian's gonna play. Julian is trying to wreck people in BlazBlue at the moment. Gonna come over here to the Guilty Gear side.
Okay, so this could be a grand finals match in any tournament. The Beautiful Dude himself versus Jason Wang, aka
GC Yoshi. Oh man. So Zato versus Bedman. Yeah, I think we got ourselves a real match right now.
It's definitely gonna be very interesting. GC Yoshi, you know, considered one of the best players in the U.S. Beautiful Dude, considered one of the better players in the U.S. also.
It's too bad it's not 3 out of 5, right?
That is too bad it's not 3 out of 5. Single Elim tournament, you know, if they met under different circumstances, I believe that this would probably be the most even matchup. The most even games that both of these players would be playing.
Yeah, so this is top 4. So Fu's out, looks like.
Yes. Knocked out by Nerd Josh.
By Nerd Josh. So one of these two will be going home, literally and figuratively.
Yes. I still have not seen the prize for Guilty Gear yet, so that's going to be very interesting. Once again, guys, Anime Expo, shouts out to Aksys. Aksys Mike over there giving out 3 lightsabers. Really great guy. Shouts out to the surrounding vicinities around us, actually. Like, these guys have been doing a really good job at kind of hooking everything up.
So, top 4 action. Winner gets into the grand finals. Bedman versus Zato. Let's go.
Jishiyoshi already with the patented jump back fireball.
Oh, there we go.
I like that OTG burst. He wants to maintain that middle screen kind of neutral game. But GC Yoshi just laying down the hurt on Beautiful Dude right now. 6P, nice reaction.
Oh, he tried to blitz it.
It would have worked if it not for the new blitz mechanics. You can only choose to blitz one way now.
Really?
Either high or low, yeah. And low does not blitz on mids anymore.
You have to get to your opening music here.
Yep. Shouts out to the amazing soundtrack in this game. Probably one of the best soundtracks of any fighting game ever. CBS2 is a close
I was going to say.
CBS2 is a really, really close one. But, you know, shades of the heavy metal tones and all that stuff, you know, what makes Guilty Gear great. It's a heavy metal fighting game.
Yep. Well, the characters are named after...
Yes.
Because he actually does take the first round, the first match, very convincingly against the beautiful dude.
Ouch, counter hit, no move.
There we go. Wow. Just like that, 50% of his life is gone.
That's Zato in a nutshell.
Right.
But little Eddie is out, so he's going to have to be playing a little bit of a waiting game.
Oh.
Alright, tags. Julian. Counter hit, Nobiru. Bag. Alright. Four dashes out of the invite hell. And tags little Eddie, but the life deficit there is a very big. Oh, could have been a big punish right there. Counter hit. Messes up the combo. POIC. Tries to maintain the corner, but it looks like this is going to be the first round.
Beautiful deal with the sunshades off, which means he's very serious right now.
Yes. These players are actually going at it. No smiles whatsoever. They want to win this tournament.
The tone in this room has definitely changed a lot. A lot of the crowd is just kind of staring in silence.
Before, you know, there's a lot of laughing going around, although people are exchanging questions and all that stuff. This room is pretty quiet.
Yeah, we're watching some top mobile play here.
Oh!
GC Yoshi with the answer. GC Yoshi on match point.
Send beautiful dude a very salty back home.
Oh.
Replay mix up, test B. He's got two symbols on the ground. Watch out for that, he's coming back. Nope, never mind, gets hit.
Takes his burst.
Oh! Not looking good for GC Yoshi right now, he's just getting countered all over the place. Takes out little Eddie, that's good. Nice block on the invite hell.
Watch his legs, here we go. Need to play with burst, so this is gonna be it. One more missile can do it.
This is the dead angle. TK, fireball, task K.
Reverse, no meter. Back to neutral. Come on. Look for one hit here. Just one hit.
All these players just getting these small little hits every now and then. I guess a command throw. This is where Julian starts. Oh! 6-8. And GC Yoshi just mashing 5B with all of his life.
This is our first game three. First game three.
This is the first game three, yes.
1-1.
Knocks little Eddie out of the park. 6-H. This is the first 6-H he's done. That's a lot of information. Nice block. Empty low. 6-H. Oh! The 6-H! That is GC Yoshi's probably his favorite mix-up. Let me 6-H you, go back to the other side and 6-H you again.
GC Yoshi on match point.
Counter hit, invite health.
Beautiful dude fighting for his tournament life.
And the Goldfish, I'm really surprised he got a Goldfish there. I thought he was throwing blocks on. Counter hit, Nobiru, but takes out little Eddie. That's very plus at the height of that screen.
Oh, no, not like this. Not like
Julian's
this,
going
no.
to get his burst back. Is he going to OTG burst? There it is.
Oh, there's the
tapped
big hit.
It. Burst save. And, there it is.
Oh.
And GC Yoshi will advance to the finals.
Yes, he's in grand finals. So Milk Kaicho and Nerd Josh will be our other side of the bracket.
That's going to be a very interesting matchup. Al Felton versus Jacko. And okay. as we know, Josh actually lost to a Jacko Nitro Noodles at CEO this year.
So. Yep. So I'm quite sure he's been in the lab practicing that matchup, you know, setting up different things. Quite sure. Dern Joss is a very technical player. He's very
old school.
Yes. You know, if I want some advice, you know, want some
from anything, like, yeah. like I would listen to Nerd Josh about life. What a like he is probably one of the most genuine people I've ever met in FGC.
Yeah, for sure.
But I can honestly say a lot of the people in the FGC have been very, very, you know, like Faulty Defense is a very genuine person.
Yeah.
Hamad, Oliver from Texas, is a very genuine person. Well, a lot of people from the West Coast, very hospitable, generous people. East Coast, I haven't really been out there too much, but you know, Alan Bakes, Stickbug, probably one of the most genuine people I've ever met. I am definitely rooming with both him and Brett this weekend. So
nice. Brett.exe.
Brett.exe. Yes. Unfortunately, that label has gone and passed for a little bit until probably in the next Frosties. Which will be fun.
It's sorry, baseball. I just have to remember that whole thing.
That was a good time. That was a very, very fun tournament. I actually had probably the most fun at that process.
Awesome. It's awesome here.
Yeah.
You know, of course, Crossing 9 will be in 2015. The dates have been announced.
Yep.
Shout out to Elven Shadow and, you know, Mini Faust.
Shouts out to Mike Bozak and his firstborn child.
Yes.
Shouts out to Kai. But right now, Milk Kaicho playing playing Jacko and Nerd Josh playing Alpha. Sorry, round 3H. Blocks 6-8. There's the Aegis. Nerd Josh is taking so much damage from these exchanges.
It's knocking me backwards,
but this is not a spot that Nerd Josh wants to be in right now.
Wow.
Punish. Tries to use Vital Express to get back on the ground, but these houses are just wrecking shop right now. Yeah, Nerd Josh is look with a very surprised look on his face.
It's like he's never seen this before.
Yes.
I'm sure that he has.
He's hitting the houses to make sure it doesn't get too out of control. OTGs. Oh, the 6-H counter. Set the house. Right. 5K is the house to break it down. Don't forget about the one of the most important houses in this game, that was the P house. So now, if you guys didn't know, the different houses have different minions that come out. The P house is the one that goes midstream. The K house is the one that is the Spider-Man walking, and the S house is the wizard. And the wizard only activates if you're in the air, and then he launches a kind of a cracking. A tracking or projectile. I will say Nerd Josh is going to be losing this first match. Yep. Needs to make a little bit of an adjustment to really face against Milk Kaicho because, you know, he's still kind of salty about that loss at CEO.
That was like 3 weeks ago. 2 weeks ago.
Still salty about that loss. Oh, nice. Gold Burst is the command throw from Jacko.
Josh being quick with one of the houses, but
these minions are just kind of flooding the board right now. Gets rid of two of them.
You shoot them in old fashioned. Oh, just a random rocket. Okay, cool.
You got so much off of that rocket, though.
I tried to put something and it just...
Yeah, I believe he thought he was just gonna go for like a jump in. But it's
instead, just getting crossed up. Oh, the counter hit. Close slash. Messes up.
Oh, a weird drop from the nerd dodge, but goes back into the corner. Renee makes up.
That angle's out. And the minions. Nerd dodge one game away from getting knocked out of this tournament. This will be a major upset.
We're doing some early offense here.
Nerdjaw's trying to just find a way in right now. Shotgun stance is a thing right now. We go for the minions. So many minions. Takes his burst. Minions are actually messing up the combo. Very scary place to be right now. Just realizing that these houses are a major problem, he's just trying to find any way to get damage on them. Whoa, the side switch. Empty low. And this should be it. No, wow, dropping the combo. Look out. Nerdjaw still has some life in him. And Nerdjaw will be knocked out of this tournament.
So Nerdjaw goes home in third place. And a relatively unknown fighting game player is now about to see if he can extend his luck to the killer extraordinaire.
GC Yoshi himself,
the executioner, the man with no heart, no soul.
I wonder what the prize is. I just really want to see somebody win so I can see the prize. I'm excited for that.
So grand finals. I had to style on stream for a little bit, but yeah, grand finals will be GC Yoshi versus Milk Kaisho. So Bedman versus Jacko.
Yeah, two very unique characters. Both of them basically playing with traps, in a sense.
Yeah. And the other one pulled straight out of an MMO game.
Yes.
So out of 32 players, they're down to two. Single elimination.
Definitely proved themselves at tournament.
So very good matches here. And of course, if this is double elim, we get some run backs, we get some setups, but this is...
Double elim is very hard to run at an anime con tournament, I'll tell you that. Especially in the middle of the dealer's hall.
Yeah. Maybe next time.
GC Yoshi using this movement so well. Empty low. That's a combo. Nice 2S. This is where she starts. Yoshi just coming down with a lot of normals with that tri dash to really put a lot of damage on this outfit. Ooh. We got a level 2S house. That is dead now.
And then that's the first burst of GC Yoshi's final tournament. He's trying to take care of houses, and he does.
Now the shield is up, so GC Yoshi cannot really put Jacko in a block stun with these the fireballs anymore. Unfortunately,
just stomps right on top of her head.
Nice DP. 6B.
Oh, burst
he really wants that's, that round.
That's kind of ill-advised, yeah. That's kind of ill-advised. GC Yoshi up one round. Is the grand final still 2 out of 3?
Yes, I believe so.
Oh, man. You're not even saved by that.
The wizard putting in so much work for him right now. Nice forward dash to get out of the minion blockade over here. And the three level 2 houses over there, so scary. I try to go for the dive kick. Should be it. Yep. No Kaisho with a lot of life in him, so.
Is there no point in putting the Heavy Slash house out?
There is no Heavy Slash house. There's only PK and S.
Okay.
Oh, block it. Nice throw. Very punishable. Six H once again. Nice convert. Pass two. Wow, the task B. Setting him behind, no catch up.
Juicy Yoshi just cruising through the finals. I don't think he's broken a sweat.
Nope. Right, early burst with no catch up. Wants to get set up. Wants to put Juicy Yoshi in the corner. Needs to get momentum. And this is where he finds it. Command throw, full combo, messes up. They're probably just not used to Redman's weight. Nice DB. Now that DB is really, really good, except it can be low profile, like not grabbing ball. Should DB it out.
He's trying to take care of the house too, isn't he? Oh, there's the shield.
Here comes the set play. Wow, TK. 360p. Yoshi's gonna die to the minions over here.
Good defense from DC Yoshi.
That defense is actually fucking immaculate. CC Yoshi living on the edge right now. And 6 H's into the projectiles.
So staying in neutral here. First half's down, but Jacko going in. Oh, try for a while, but that's the big hit.
It's blocked.
Oh.
Basic gold burst, but it's a gold burst, so cannot run it.
Super? Can you give us some houses here? Nope.
Oh wow, actually, I'm not sure how no Kaito actually got hit with it. Flip it up. No Kaito looking very strong in this match against DC Yoshi right now. Holding on to his burst.
And now, we're tied 1-1. The final game, final match, the final set.
GC Yoshi versus Milk Kaijo. Who would have thought this would be our grand final? Jacko Bedman.
Oh, an early burst from Jacko. Milk Kaijo over here. DC Yoshi was working on first, but nope, and he bursts out as well, so it's two early bursts.
Now both of these bursts did connect, so they have a little bit in stock.
Right.
Depending on how this match goes, both of these players might be able to get a trick set.
Here comes the Vortex. Oh, and he's looking for the... No. What's up? Okay, cool. Get the wall bounce, gets right back to the combo. Throw right to the corner. Next up here, what?
GC Yoshi in a really bad spot right now. All the minions.
Goes low, all the minions are just surrounding him.
Oh, gets a 5-H.
Vortex,
nice block. Gets thrown back into the corner.
Got a Calvados. Bad, and that's me.
Not yet. Guts. Oh, and he takes the burst.
Wow.
Now, GC Yoshi down a burst. One match away from losing.
And Milk Kaijo on tournament point.
All right,
burst. That's it.
both these players dealing with no burst.
All the minions in the corner. Okay, so let's mix up here.
Based off of that angle.
But gets up with the overhead and. And Zekko made a round. He has RCs to get it.
Nice.
RCs to get the round and.
Juicy Yoshi keeping himself alive. No Kaisho actually built his burst back while he was getting messed up right there. Nice 6-8.
Final round.
In the corner again against Jacko. Just side switch.
Oh boy.
Counter hit 6-8.
Put Jacko back in the corner.
Pass B. Nice DP to, against that 6-8. Jacko's 6-B, or DP is actually very good for situations like that. Nice DP yet again. No meter now.
Oh no. That's how it starts
again.
Right here. That's how it starts.
The shield is out. Not anymore.
Purple RC.
One more hit. If the gold burst is there. Setting up all these houses. And getting taken out by that Try Dash Jump K, and your Anime Expo 2016 champion is GC Yoshi once again. Congratulations to Jason. Let's give a round of applause to Milk Kaicho also. Very, very solid Jacko play. And then also to the beautiful dude and Fu.
Fu and Nerd Josh.
And Nerd Josh. We're all coming all the way to Anime Expo to play at this tournament. Oh,
yeah,
capped at 32, so very, very good stuff to these guys. Yeah.
Very good stuff.
Now I believe there might be a prize announcement or something like that.
Yeah, we have no idea what's going to be the first prize for this, but that's something maybe we should find out.
But once again, guys, this was the Guilty Gear Revelator tournament. Tomorrow we will be hosting the BlazBlue first console tournament at Anime Expo. So please tune in, same time, same channel, for your dose of anime. Thank you once again, guys. We're at Anime Expo. I am NobodyXE,
Will Anglis the Fourth.
Please follow us on Twitter and like, donate, subscribe, follow our streamer, Joshua. Thank you so much for having us, guys.
Have a good night.
We're out.